So vision, your sense of vision, your ability to see, is relayed via your optic nerve or cranial nerve too. The neurons for this cranial nerve originate in the neural retina. Most of the, or half of these axons are going to cross at a structure called the optic chiasm. In this slide, we can see the optic nerve in situ. The eyes are kind of down in this region, and the optic nerve then comes through the optic canal, and you can see it coming right under the edge of the frontal bones right here. So here's the optic nerve. So if not that you'd ever really want to know this, but if you're going to take a brain out of a skull, you got to cut the optic nerve to do it. And here on the undersurface of the brain, again, we can see our beautiful olfactory bulb and our olfactory tract. And here we can see the cut ends of the optic nerve. Just posterior towards, or caudally towards the back of the brain, is a structure called the optic chiasm. And that's right here. And that optic chiasm, let's just erase this so you can see it better. The optic chiasm is where half of your optic axons are going to cross. So the visual fields are set up in a way that we have a nasal visual field, which is up against the retina that's against your nose, and a lateral area of of your visual field that's called the temporal. The temporal part of your retina actually sees images coming in from the nasal part of your visual field. So it's a little confusing. Let me draw it for you and see if this makes sense. So if your nose is kind of here and your eyeball is here, and then your retina is across the back. This part of your retina sees this part of the visual field. This part of your retina sees that part. So this is going to be the temporal, and this is going to be the nasal. So as you're learning about neuroscience, and when you get into a more in-depth course, and they're going to talk about areas of the retina, the nasal retina or the temporal retina, and then they'll talk about visual fields, nasal and temporal, and they're different. So just keep that in mind as you study in the future. To reiterate the crossing of these fibers from the retina, if I have a retina up here, and I have my optic nerve that's leaving, half of the fibers are going to stay on one side, and half of the fibers are going to cross to the other side. And in my other eyeball, I've got half of the fibers crossing over and half staying on the same side. So this represents the optic chiasm. That's all I want you to know for now, the half cross and half don't. The ins and outs of the visual system and all of the projections are very complicated and are beyond what we have time to talk about in this MOOC. But if you're really, really interested, I'm sure that there's another MOOC out there somewhere that talks really in depth about the visual system. So I want to point out the different parts of this pathway within the brain. And so in an anterior piece of the brain here, we can see that we're anterior in the brain. We see the lateral ventricles. We see a little bit of our third ventricle. And here are the optic nerves just coming together to right in front of the chiasm. In this image, we're a little bit more, we're probably about in the middle of the brain. Again, we have our lateral ventricle and our third ventricle here on the midline. And here is the optic chiasm in all of its glory. So half the fibers are crossing, half are not. A little bit more posterior in the brain, we have again our lateral ventricle, a little bit of our third ventricle here, and this is now the optic tract. And we call the pathway the optic tract after the chiasm. So it goes nerve, chiasm, tract. The optic tract specifically projects to an area of the thalamus called the lateral geniculate. Nucleus or lateral geniculate body of the thalamus. We'll talk more about the lateral geniculate and some of the other important nuclei of the thalamus when we talk about the cerebral cortex and some of the deep gray matter. But this is a way station for visual processing on the way, on its way to that occipital cortex, which of course you know is in your occipital lobe, where vision comes to perception. In this slide, what we can see, it's a horizontal section of the brain, and it's above the level of the optic chiasm and the optic nerve. But what we can see are the fibers that are leaving the thalamus, which is this midline structure, and we'll talk more about the thalamus later. But there's a big bundle of fibers right here that's exiting the thalamus and headed toward the occipital cortex. We call this the optic radiations. Radiation. I am not the best speller. And that is how information gets from the thalamus to the occipital cortex. So from the retina through the optic nerve to the optic chiasm. At the optic chiasm, half the fibers cross and half do not. Post chiasm, we call it the optic tract. The optic tract then goes to the thalamus, and then from the thalamus, it goes to the occipital cortex via the optic radiations. In the next segment, we'll talk about the special sense of taste.